So, Admiral, when can the troops expect you, sir?
What do you mean?
The royal orders you were given. You're supposed to join forces with the ground troops, sir. The general has been very clear. He expects you to be there.
I don't doubt that's what he wants.
What? All respect to you, Admiral. The enemy has a massive ship set to come this way. We're starting to see several of your men deserting their posts.
He is correct. We've counted at least 50 deserters. So far.
Just please tell us what you're thinking, Admiral. The enemy has 200 ships prepared and are ready to invade us at any moment now. What strategy have you developed? Show us. Show us what plan you have in mind to defeat the enemy. Let's hear from the young officers at the table. Do you think we can win? Do you? Don't any of you have an opinion for the Admiral? Admiral, you need to erase all of the doubt here. Aside from using that damaged turtle ship, what do you plan on doing?
You best remember you're addressing our commander.
How dare you! You should remember your place here. I'm your superior officer.
You don't deserve to hold any rank. We all know the truth about you, that you fled from Chil Chongyang.
Shut your mouth! Do you know why we have those 12 ships out there? Because I saved them from being destroyed in the battle. You keep your mouth shut when you don't know the truth. Admiral, you know as well as anyone this battle is futile. You know the kind of power our enemy has, and how they're brutal and relentless. They're going to defeat you. Why do you insist on sending men into a battle they'll never win?
This meeting is adjourned. Dismissed.
Admiral!
He's given us a direct order! We have to obey it. Our main priority is to repair the ships and train the men. Get to it!
It's clear that we have to capture King Sanjo to end this war once and for all. We can't just let him slip through our fingers like he has been able to do to us before. We must have a solid plan and coordinate a perfect storm. You agree?
Yes, Commander. Sanjo is our rightful prize. We can't allow Konishi to dethrone him first.
Of course, but Chancellor Hideyoshi wants us to wait for his man to arrive before we make our move. So, it seems that's the only option we have for right now. Wakizaka's ships are arriving.
Yes, sir. Those are his ships. They've been on a reconnaissance mission.
I hope they have good information. How many trips?
They've done two already, and they've been good missions. So then, what do we know about the help being sent to us? Has the Chancellor told you anything at all?
The only thing I've been told is that it's someone essential to the battle. His goal is to take on Yi Sun Shin and make sure he won't be an issue for us any longer.
Finished yet? Do you pay for this with your head?
Yeah! Ah!
I don't want to interfere. I just couldn't simply pass by or ignore it.
Who are you, sir? Are you the one who was sent to us by the Chancellor?
Swarming with activity, Admiral. They have over 200 warships docked. They're moving supplies onto the ships, and they're stealing provisions from the villagers who are too weak to stop them. If anyone resists, they cut their nose off their face. They also use children for target practice. It looks to me like they're almost ready. They're on the verge of deployment.
What's the status of their reinforcements? Do they really have 25,000 soldiers en route?
Yes, sir. That's how it appears. They're brazen. They're not worried about our navy in any way. And they talk about how they'll storm our capital with ease and little resistance from us.
We must do something. or else our capital will bleed. Deliver this to Junsai as fast as you can, and then report back to me.
Yes, Admiral. Sweetheart. A talisman? This isn't my first mission, but I'll treasure it for sure. I gotta go. Be sure to stay strong!
Tell me, is Yi disobeying the royal orders again?
He's pursuing what he believes is logical.
I cannot promise his safety if he disobeys the royal orders given to him.
The provinces in the south are decimated. Japan's ground forces are headed north. That's for certain. Our capital could be destroyed. If we don't stop their navy, it'll be unavoidable.
But what can he do with those measly 12 ships of his?
Well, you're the one who expects the men on those ships to be of value to the army.
Don't be insubordinate. In any case, the Admiral isn't in good health.
Do you need to be reminded, sir, who caused that?
Wadjet. Can you even comprehend what we're about to be up against exactly? You certainly know of Kiyomasa, don't you? He's about to be at our gate, destroying it! So many men are needed if we're to have any hope of stopping him! Grab him!
Let's go!
Please, General, help us. You have to support our Admiral. Our Navy is just not prepared to face that brutal enemy.
So, obey the orders, then.
General, our request is done in earnest. I can't believe you'd abandon us.
How dare you speak that way? You'll now suffer the punishment. What are you all waiting for? Take him this instant and put him away.
No,
General!
General! Hear me! The Admiral wishes to convey these words! To forfeit the sea is to forfeit Joseon! General! General! General!
I've been waiting now half a day. Is this how you treat all the guests you host here?
I'm afraid our planning you see here got in the way of us being good hosts. My sincere apologies. Now then, we could use a little enlightenment from a pirate. How would you kill a king? Share with us your wisdom, huh?
I've surveyed the region for opportunities to advance. We'll take advantage of the morning tide and ride through the strait. We can then resupply the troops by night and sail into the capital. If it's done right, we'll arrive in a day and a half, I estimate.
That's easier said than done. Yi Sun Shin, can't be taken lightly. There's one way to assure a victory. Sailing the open sea and approaching the capital to annihilate Yi with the army is the best strategy.
What do you think is about to happen here? Why'd Hideyoshi send for me, Wakizaka?
How dare you do that? You never should have uttered his name!
Yi Sun Shin will be crushed by my hand. Or maybe Konishi gets to the capital first ahead of you.
I don't think there's a need for this much tension. Would you please forgive my men for any hastiness? Do sit. Let you and I work this out, Kurushima.
Father, it's Ho.
Are you happy that you're here, son?
I am. But, sir...
Speak freely.
You should get out of this mess. Why not blame your ailing health and just return home? We haven't even held a proper funeral for Grandmother. We only have the temporary shrine. Our men should join with the army. And you should go home to be able to heal.
I can feel the resentment you harbor toward our king.
The man tried to take your life from you. How come you don't feel resentment? Father, we only have 12 ships to bring to battle. We can hardly call ourselves a navy. It's shameful. If somehow you do lead these men to victory, the king will surely abandon you again. Why do you even consider fighting?
Loyalty.
But, sir, he doesn't even reciprocate it.
My boy, a commander's loyalty is forever with his king. And his loyalty belongs to his entire nation.
But what if he abuses it?
People create the nation, son. A king has nothing without his people.
But that's a problem. So many are myopic. They have no concern about any other people.
Please finish your dinner. The food is precious.
You all see this? That's Captain Bay. Captain Bay Hong Suk.
Sorry.
Not the flagship!
Captain Bane, no.
What are we gonna do with this?
Tell me, Kurushima, did you really behead the prisoners and send them back?
Only after I cut off their noses and removed their ears.
Well, great. I see we're going to have to deal with your foolishness. What's the use of this senseless provocation of the enemy?
Why not? It'll at least make for an interesting fight. Of course, that assumes that they'll actually fight.
You'll learn the hard way. Our enemy is strong and formidable!
You know, I hear your men talk of Yi Sun Shin's prowess with great reverence. Perhaps the fact that you were so summarily defeated in Hansan has shrunk your testicles.
That's the last you'll talk like that!
Let me make this clear to you. I'm here at the Chancellor's direct request. He knows that you're too weak to take on the likes of Yi Sun Shin in battle. Don't be so reckless towards me, or your head might be the first one to fall. My brother, Michiyuki, became a minion in service to the Chancellor. He perished on his quest to conquer the capital city, Joseon. I was facing the Chancellor's wrath, so he joined this war to save me. His life was taken by Yi Sun Shin's own hand. It happens now that the Chancellor has fallen ill. He probably has a year left at the most. That's why he's rushing the campaign along. And at such a quick pace. He's bound and determined to take down Joseon once and for all. I will make that city fall. So you see, Yi Sun Shin has to be made to suffer and perish. Is that clear, Haru? My hope is this will serve as some sort of revenge. My brother's deserving of as much.
Why did he do it?
Is it that Sangu? It is! Sangu! He got caught trying to flee!
We caught him trying to run away near Blood Isle, Admiral.
Sir, you have to understand that I lost all of my comrades of 6 years at Jilchongnyong. Earlier today, I had to bury them with my own hands. I just can't take this anymore. I felt I had no other choice but to run. I know that my death is unavoidable now. But must every one of us have to die for a losing battle?
Are you about done, Sangu? Understand this. Discipline is crucial. For everyone!
There's no backing out of this now, I'm afraid. He's willing to murder his own people.
Maybe so, but we might have a way.
The strait creates a bottleneck here, which makes the current strong and unwieldy. They say it can become so treacherous that no ship has a chance for escape.
I don't know about this. They'll come this way, if they see it as an advantage. And probably, they're thinking that it just might be an advantage for them. Look at those waves, Admiral. They'll be able to ride those waves and ram into our ships, tearing them apart. We won't survive this.
That's why a working turtle ship is imperative. We'll use it to break their front line. Using our warships, we'll fire our cannons from a distance.
It takes half a day for the tide to change. Can the turtle ship hold out that long?
When the tide changes, the sea calms down considerably. But listen, can you hear that sound? It's a different sound than it was before. It's changed. It's ominous. Sort of like a man that's howling. The real problem is the whirlpool. You rarely hear that during a semi-diurnal. But if you do, you can be certain you're in for a lot of trouble, because that's when the whirlpool appears. The semi-diurnal is in 2 days. And so then,
Chil-Chan-Yung.
I've been wondering, is the turtle ship your only tactic?
The problem's not my tactics. It's the fear. It's quickly spreading among my men. It is like a virus.
Can the men overcome this fear? And what becomes of our force if they can't? What about what you did today? You beheaded one of your own men. That's how you create discipline? How does that lead to victory? Tell me. How does that possibly...
We can use it.
What? You mean the fear?
Please join me for a drink. Please just stay for a drink. Man, where are you all going? Captain Lee, Hong-sook. Please, Monsieur Rochard.
Saul's first mate.
Join me! Help!
Yisun Shin's turtle ship has been completely destroyed by fire.
Are you sure?
A scout was sent when we noticed a fire. He returned with his report. He confirmed that the ship was engulfed in flames and was quickly reduced to ashes.
That was Yi's last one, isn't that right, General?
Yes, it was, Commander. Yisun Shin won't be using any turtle ships.
Dato Moomoon, do not look back when the only course is in front of you. Very nice, sir. Your calligraphy, it is inspirational. Your words are masterful.
My words are chosen for what's needed at this juncture.
I'm from a fishing village, you see? I can row. I'm strong, and I can row very well. Oh, wait, I'm really good.
What's he jabbering about?
See, look at this.
What the hell?
Subong.
You little rat!
I've got you now!
Wait, I'm sorry! Please don't kill me!
Quiet down!
message from Junsa!
We'll reach Nyongyang tomorrow morning. We deploy with the tide, and the fleet is over 330 ships. Unfortunately, they brought in somebody new as the captain of their vanguard ships. His name is Kurushima, known as the Pirate King, and versed in similar conditions. Fortunately, backing him up is General Wakizaka, whom you defeated once before in Hansan. I hope you find some comfort in this. I will join you soon, once I fulfill my duty.
Let's go to Usuyong.
Sir?
We cannot fight with the strait behind us. We have to move all of our men as soon as we can.
From General Konishi.
The general is pressing me about the invasion.
Don't worry. We'll reach the king before he's able to get to him. It's time now for deployment.
I must say, Joseon looks particularly savory to me. I think I do like this land quite a lot.
Captain.
Status.
All prepared, sir. There are only POWs below deck now. And we have stockpiled all of the gunpowder. Yi's a dead man. I promise. He won't survive this.
One turtle ship! How does a formation of a single line qualify as a tactic? The Admiral's lost his senses.
The captain's right. Just listen to that out there. I refuse for us to die in vain. We can't let him go forward with this. We must take some action.
What are you implying with that kind of thought? Are you suggesting we make a plan to assassinate the Admiral?
How dare you? That's not what I'm saying at all.
Okay, then. We're running out of time to do something, and we can't even send a message successfully up the ranks now.
Let's go to him.
Why do that?
I'll convince the Admiral. And if I fail, I'll tell him to take my life right there.
Your Majesty, if you disband the Navy now, I'm afraid the enemy will be able to get to you. And they'll do so basically free of any resistance. I still have 12 ships at my command. If we fight to our last breath, it is not impossible. As long as I still have life within me. The enemy shall never feel safe on our soil.
Admiral, at the risk of my own life, I'd like the chance to speak my mind. This is futile. You'll kill our men!
Please hear us!
If by some miracle you're able to lure them into the Strait, we'll be defeated easily, without a turtle ship at our disposal. Please reconsider it, Admiral. I beg you.
We beg you!
Is that how you see the situation?
If you think otherwise, sir, then take my life as I kneel before you. I would rather die by your sword, Admiral!
Then if that is how you really feel, Captain, very well. Go and get your men. Have them group up in front of the camp.
Yes, sir!
Yes, sir!
Captains Kim and Hwang, have you brought what I asked?
Yes, Admiral!
Pour it. Why aren't you pouring it?
Pour it!
Yes, sir!
And now light it!
Sir! Sir!
What are you doing?
It's truly shameful how you carry yourselves. You should have concern for more than your own lives. Dying is an unavoidable fate. You think avoiding combat will guarantee your survival through this? Is the land a safer place? Follow your admiral! I am burning our land now, so I may die at sea. We must make a stand together and take on our enemy. You have to make a sacrifice. If survival is your goal, then you'll surely lose. You only survive if you're willing to die. A proper strategy allows for a man by himself to fend off 1,000 men. We are him. We will take on our enemy no matter what their size.
father. You've created the fear. How will you utilize it for a victory?
Is this Captain Beihong Suk's son?
Yes, sir. This is him. He's the one who brought us Junsa's message. Junsa ran into him by chance and helped him escape.
This was your father's. Please take it. So tell me your name.
Pei Subong, sir.
With your father at my side, we fought the enemy for 6 years. I'll remember his name and your name too.
Sir, I have a request.
Make it then.
I would like to come aboard your ship and help in the battle.
Only if you'll accept an oar rather than a sword.
Absolutely. Thank you, sir.
I must be off now, but I will surely see you soon. My only hope is that our deaths will not be in vain. Good work.
We are with you, Admiral.
You're very noble. I appreciate that.
deployment. Let's head out.
Listen up! We're moving out! This war is your destiny! Deploy!
Deploy!
Get into battle formation.
Go get it.
Look at all those ships over there!
Oh no!
It's retreating!
Oh. Close the portals!
Swung! I think we got on the wrong ship.
Didn't know it was the flagship?
Yeah. But why does it have to be the one at the front, though?
I will order our fleet to get into formation.
Let him go.
Sir? Then what do we do?
Lower the anchor and get ready to fight.
Lower the anchor!
Yisun Shin isn't raising his command flag.
Well, look at what his fleet's doing. If he did signal a command, would they even obey it?
Advance the first vanguard.
Vanguard 1! Advance!
Take starboard and prepare the cannons.
Stop the starboard oars! Port oars, move faster!
Lieutenant Na, Captain, aim all cannons and explosive arrows directly at their vanguard ships.
Yes, sir. Move all of the cannons into attack position! Aim at the vanguard!
Archers! Battle stations! Aim!
Prepare to fire! Set your range!
Shit!
far, Yi Sun Shin is concentrating his attack on our front line. Vanguard ships are colliding into one another.
Yi's holding position. He's either courageous or a complete madman. I wish I knew what was inside his head.
Don't you think we need to join in the next wave and reinforce the front?
No. We need patience when dealing with him.
Fear does not discriminate. It can distress our enemy as effectively as it does us. You can rest assured that 6 years of defeat has planted fear in many of their minds as well.
He spoke the truth. Fear is not discriminating. So tell me, how do we make fear an advantage?
Mold it into courage. Then it can become our greatest weapon.
Send in Vanguard 2, and press them harder.
Yes, sir.
Vanguard 2! Advance!
Look at that. Kurashima keeps sending in ships.
He's very skilled at handling the roughest of tides. Let's see what choices he makes from here now.
Just watch. The currents give us the greatest advantage for the time being. We will be able to overrun and demolish them completely.
Admiral, the currents have gotten too strong. Our accuracy is down.
Cut the anchor. We will ride the currents in the direction of Blood Isle.
Yes, Admiral.
We'll change up.
Load the cannons with shrapnel shells.
And prepare for close combat.
On guard! Prepare for close combat!
like Kurishima is about to win the battle. Admiral Yi held on as long as he could. Gather up all of the cannons on board, and then put them in the port oar of the ship. Can you do that?
I don't think that's a good idea.
Just get it done!
Okay, I'll do it, Admiral.
Hold your ground!
How do we make fear an advantage?
Mold it into courage. Then it can become our greatest weapon. Once fear manifests courage, it will inspire even more courage.
But Father, how do we begin the process? What can be done to inspire the men?
My own sacrifice.
could this be? Is this the end of the battle? The Whirlpool. There it is.
Yisun Shin. So, that's the reason you decided to hold out there.
The current has changed, and now a large whirlpool is forming.
Thanks to that, the water is calm near the island, which greatly increases their accuracy. If he holds up there now, that'll make it nearly impossible for anyone to pass through the strait. Then the battle is done. Take us out at maximum speed, and head for Yi's flagship before he gets in formation. He is not going to win this!
Yes, sir!
Sir, that's their main fleet.
Raise the flag up.
Yes, Admiral.
You're mine.
As mandated by martial law. But since we're engaged in battle, you're sentenced to fight to the death. You must defend Blood Isle with everything you have. Do you understand?
Yes, Admiral!
Captain, as quickly as possible, get us to the center of the street.
Yes, Admiral.
To the center of the street!
Impeccable timing, sir. The explosion it'll create is going to be rather massive. We won't fall for Yi Sun Shin's trap. Our main fleet will continue toward the isle.
Sir! A straw-covered ship is approaching.
Archers in formation.
Yes, sir! Fire!
We're sitting ducks here!
Lift it up!
We're out of shells on the deck!
Vessel is carrying gunpowder.
Admiral, we have to do something to stop it.
Our scout Im is on board.
We better come up with something quick.
From on ship?
Hold strong!
answer! They don't see the flag!
Get their attention! Make them fire at me! Please, you've got to be strong! They gotta know. This mustn't... Get to the Admiral's ship! You must!
Ship's headed for the flagship!
Prepare the cannons! Get ready to fire!
Sir!
Got to see you one final time.
Admiral, their Vanguard flagship is heading for us.
Thank you.
reinforce? Short-handed! Help those on deck and make yourselves useful!
Reinforcements!
We're stuck out here on our own. There's no support coming now. They are not sending reinforcements.
What do you think? Should we help him?
Tell me, are you a spy or are you a traitor?
Sir, it doesn't look good. I'm afraid our ship is failing.
Before they get into formation! Why aren't we going faster?
The tide has turned, sir. It's slowing us down.
I know that. Whip the rowers. Make them row faster. Just take a look out there. We need increased speed, and we need it now! Full speed! Row your hardest!
Just let go!
Hang on!
When is this going to end?
is your order.
It rose from the dead.
The turtle ships return! The turtle ships return! The turtle ships
Bennett. He was counting on that all along.
Retreat. Turn us around. The tides are favorable for us once again.
They can try to invade us all they want. We're not letting them get shit, am I right?
Here, have some.
I'm already eating one.
Yes!
I looked one of those bastards in the eye, and he pissed his pants right there. I'm a bad man.
I wonder if history is gonna remember how hard we fought.
Yeah, it will. Every damn minute.
You speak the truth.
They're all still breathing. Guess it's time to go back home.
Here, have a drink.
This is Toro, isn't it? It feels good to eat again. What can be done to ease their pain, their suffering?
Father, how did you come up with that idea to use the whirlpool? Father?
Hmm? What were you asking?
Right when we needed it, that whirlpool appeared. If that hadn't have happened then...
It's the grace of God.
Grace of God? You mean... we could have been defeated?
Yes. Yes, indeed. Thank God for the peasants. If they weren't there to save me, then...
The peasants were the grace of God? Not the whirlpool?
Well, what do you think? What's more likely to be the grace of God?
Over there. What is that?